Hello guys and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we'll discuss about a pattern program. That is, we need our output in this pattern. That is, a single star in first line, 2 star in the second line, 3 star in the third line, 4 star in the fourth line, etc. So we'll see how to write a program to get output like this. Before going to the program, we'll see what are the requirements of the program. That is, first input, that is, we'll ask the user to enter the input, that is how many rows he want. We can see this pattern contains 5 rows, but in our program we'll ask the user to enter the number of rows. Second one is for loop. For this program we need 2 for loop, that is, we can see here rows and columns. So for row we need 1 for loop, for columns we need another for loop, so we need 2 for loop. And third is range function. In our program we are using range function. We already discussed about the range function in our tutorial, and again I'll explain you. And in the range function we'll use key as range, and it takes 2 arguments, one is start and one is end. And range function is used to print the continuous number. That is, if I want 0 to 10 numbers, then I can mention here, that is 0, and I need to mention 11 here. It's because here 0 is included here and 11 is excluded. That is, if I want integer from 0 to 10, then I need to mention 0 and 11 here. Okay, if you want to see this, I'll use for loop in range 0 to 11. And here we can see, if I want 0 to 10 numbers, then I need to mention 0 and 11 here. And to print continuous numbers we'll use range function. And next last is print function. That is, if we type help and print, and this is the syntax of print function, and here we can see end is slash n. That is, if I use print function here and I'll write hello and I'll separate this, next I'll write next line, that is print hi. Okay, now I'll enter. We can see hello and hi in different lines. Once it will write this hello message to the screen. As we see in the print syntax, end is equal to slash n, and we didn't mention anything here, so by default it will go to the next line and it will print the next message. And here print hello, and I'll change this end to space. I'll separate this and I'll use print hi. Okay, now I'll enter this. We can see hello and hi in the same line, and it is separated by a space. It's because we use end as space here. Okay, now we'll go to our pattern program, and first we need to ask the user to enter the input. So I'll use one variable called num, and I'll ask the user to enter the number of rows, and it is an integer value, so I'll use int. Input function, enter the number of rows. Okay, now I'll use for loop. It is first for loop for rows, so for I in range function, and I'll take the value from 1, so 1 to num plus 1. As I said, in the range function it is included and this value is excluded. If the user entered the value 5, Then we want value 1 to 5. So I mentioned num plus 1. So it is 6 now. So it will give the values 1 to 5. And here within the for function, I'll use another for and j in range. Here also I'll use 1 and I plus 1. Okay. Now I'll print. I want to print star, right? So I'll print star here. And here I'll mention end is equal to space. Okay. Now I'll go out of this for loop. And in the first for loop, I'll write a print function. And now I'll save this and run this. Now enter the number of rows. I'll enter 5. And here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right? Okay, first here we'll ask the user to enter the number of rows. So we entered 5 here. So value of num is 5. Okay. And coming to the for loop, range 1 to num plus 1. So range value is 1 and 6. Okay. So it will give 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. Now first I value is 1 here. Next it will go to the jth loop. And here its range is 1 to I plus 1. So now here range is 1 to I plus 1, that is 2. So it will give 1. J value is 1 here. So it will go to the print statement and it will print the star and it will take end as space and again it will go to the for loop. But here in the range function it will give only one value, that is 1. So it is already executed. So it will come out of this loop and it will execute this print statement, that is it will give new line. So we got first star and the control goes to the next line now. Next, here again it will go to the for loop and now I value is 2. So I value is 2 now. And again it will go to the for loop. Because of the I value is 2, here it is 1 to I plus 1, that is 1 to 3. 1 and 3. So it will give value 1 and 2. Now again j value is 1. And it will print this star, that is this star. And next it will print this space. Again it will go to this loop and now j value will be incremented to 2 and it will go to this print statement and it will print this star. Okay, after this here range function gives only 2 value. So after this it will come out of this loop and it will print this, so it will go to the next line. Like this it will continue the execution and it will print this pattern. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.